in the last age, the Dajjal will be released. And when he is released on earth, the Dajjal will have a general mission, and he will have a specific mission. His general mission is to test all of mankind, to test you, to see whether you have any faith at all. All those who fail his test are heading for the fire. His test will be an awesomely difficult test. So great will be the test and the trial to which mankind will be subjected by Dajjal. Then the Prophet said, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he said that the greatest fitna,
fitna means a test and a trial,
he said that the greatest fitna that mankind will experience from the time of Adam alayhi salam to the last day is the fitna of Dajjal. So don't play around with this subject.
Very serious.
How do you deal with religious symbolism, particularly in the context of the end times, of the end times, of the end times, of the end times?
The Blessed Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam declared, every prophet warned his people about the Antichrist, about Dajjal, the false Messiah. And the Prophet Noah warned his people. But I say to you something that none ever said before me. The Antichrist sees with one eye, his left eye. He's blind in the right eye. It looks like a bulging great. But your Lord is not one eye.
During the time that the Dajjal was launching his attack from Britain, the Holy Land was liberated of non-Jewish rule. During the time that Britain was hosting the Dajjal, the Jews came back to the Holy Land. And during the time that the Dajjal was launching his attack from Britain, the state of Israel was restored. Three out of four already delivered.
The Messenger of Allah, Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam, informed us of the release of Dajjal into the world during his lifetime.
During his lifetime.
He went on to say that when Dajjal is released into the world, he would live on earth for 40 days. One day like a year, one day like a month, one day like a week, and the rest of the days like your days. The analysis conducted in this book
in such that it argues the middle class will be behaving, which is like, yeah, Britain was with headquarters. And when the Dow moves to a day which is like a month, the United States of America became a quarter. And finally, when the Dow is going to be a day which is like a week, you come back home to the Holy Land. You come back home to the Holy Land.
Begin with definition. Dajjal is a being, a wujud. Dajjal was created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He created him in his wisdom. And when Allah created Dajjal, Allah endowed Dajjal with awesome power, with awesome versatility. And Dajjal was created at that time when Adam alayhi salam was created. Because the Prophet said, he said that every prophet has warned his people about the Dajjal. Every prophet. So the Dajjal has been created a long time ago. Subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfilled his promise and sent the Messiah to them, they rejected him. Not all.
No.
There were some Jews who accepted him. But there are others who rejected him. They rejected him because they declared that he's a bastard. His mother gave birth to him without a father, without any husband. And therefore she had committed that vile deed of zina. He's a bastard. A bastard cannot be the Messiah. So they rejected him. And then later on, when they saw him die on the cross, before their very eyes they saw him die, it was now confirmed that although he himself claimed that he was the Messiah, and although there were many Jews who believed in him as the Messiah, the rabbis had rejected him, it was now confirmed he could not have been the Messiah. Why? Number one, he said, but the Holy Land has not been liberated. It is still under Roman rule. Number two, he's dead. But the state of Israel has not been restored. Number three, he's dead. But the state of Israel has not risen to become the ruling state in the world. And he has not ruled the world from Jerusalem. A number of reasons. So he could not have been the Messiah. Tomorrow night or Thursday night I'll give you some more reasons. And so they're waiting for the Messiah to come. If the Dajjal is to deceive Banu Israel and get them to be convinced that he is the Messiah, look at what he will have to do. Number one, He will have to liberate the Holy Land of non-Jewish rule. Number two, he'll have to bring Banu Israel back to the Holy Land. No matter how long they had lived outside of the Holy Land, he'll have to bring them back. Number three, he will have to restore the state of Israel. And number four, he will have to take the state of Israel to that status where it will become the ruling state in the world. And he himself will then have to rule the world from Jerusalem. That's not an easy task at all for the Jews. The Dajjal will not only test all of mankind, and tonight we will look at some of the tests, but the Dajjal has a specific mission. His mission is to impersonate Al-Masih and to get Banu Israel to believe that he is Al-Masih. And so in order to understand the Dajjal in his capacity as Al-Masih for the Dajjal, we need first to understand who or what is Al-Masih. So Dajjal will enter into our dimension of time one day. We see him. But prior to that, in a day which is like a year, where will he be? It is from that location that he will commence his attack. He will begin his effort. Number one, to liberate the Holy Land. Number two, to bring the Jews back to the Holy Land. Number three, to restore the state of Israel. Number four, you know it's number four. From that location, he will begin to go there, but where will it be? Fortunately for us, we have the answer.